Chilling with the multi alter ego genius here. Okay, Mlazi Milano, aka Sounds Of Mzansi, aka Future Mfana, aka many AKAs.
AKA Mlazi Milano.
Yeah. Be careful. Dog, okay, so I'm gonna jump straight to Mlazi Milano, dog. Okay. So what an interesting trip you took people on. Take me through like the importance of you going, because you I feel like you tell the story throughout all your digital platforms. Like I just saw recently you went back on your Insta to your old school.
Yeah, I think similar as Nin. Last weekend we had a show there for charity.
Dope.
You know, this cat was like, yo, I'm throwing a birthday bash, but we're gonna buy school shoes for all the kids around my neighborhood.
Nice.
Ebonela,
yeah.
Mavo.
Because
my mom's house now is in a very historical place in Durban. So we do a lot of stuff like for people around the neighborhood. Still very poor. So I did something like that, a charity thing for that guy. And then the next day we just went and saw Mlazi, shot some stuff for the documentary, because we work on a documentary from Mlazi Milano. Yeah, I'm working with Dame Arumo.
Yes.
So, you know, we're learning each other. I'll give him some movies, he gives me some movies.
Yeah.
We watch a lot of visuals right now, just like, yo, did you see that scene from 1:3 to 6 minutes?
Yeah.
And then
yeah.
he'll go and it's like, yo, that's crazy. Maybe we can try to do something like that, you know?
How important is it for you? Like, I feel like, the thing is, like, I feel like you're already in 2025, right? And everybody else is like just following suit. How important is it for you to like do that? Because you like I heard Mlazi Milano before it came out because you displayed it on your Insta.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You told that story, like.
Yeah, exactly.
We were already like bumping to the joints that you were. We were like, hey, we can't wait for this joint to come out. Like, I think you were reciting like lines from La Liga.
Oh yeah.
How important is that for you? Because like,
the
traditional way is hold it and then
guy
or now my poor man.
Yeah, no, I think it's really important for me because because I'm independent, so I don't have I do have a structure now that's actually helping me. Shout out to Electromode.
Oh, really?
They're really helping me out, but in terms of the media the content stuff,
it's really
me and Dame Arumo, because the whole thing I dropped it under a studio, Shambok Studios.
Yes.
So I could have opted for a record label, but I opted for a studio because I want to do a lot of products, you know.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So it's really important for me to have that power, just like for me actually to wake up and eat it. Actually, let me share this thing now. Get shy.
Yeah.
And then
you make the call.
Yeah, exactly.
When it feels right.
Now, exactly.
Yeah.
And with that, usually, because the internet is quite a tricky one. Like, if you went online and you wanted to pour out your heart into a post, it really, really resonates.
Sure.
But if it's a post that the copywriter wrote and then it went through and then they checked it out.
Yeah.
It's like,
perfect. That's a loony scene. Sounds right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, it's different. And it's like, for me, I feel closer to the tribe, or rather my fans, you know, like that. Yeah.
Exactly. Please just tell people what Smiso means. Just like
Smiso.
Like for people who don't know what the name
is. It's crazy. You're the second person today to ask me that.
Really?
Like, I had another interview. But it's like something that's meant to be.
Yeah.
Or you could also put it as somebody who's here to change perspective. Yeah, exactly. So
your album's got like 17,000 genres. Mlazi Milano. Why, dog?
Yeah, I think that it's been like that since day one, Daddy Parfait.
Yeah.
It's always been like I remember the first song I wrote for Daddy Puff, you know, was Big Booty Holly.
Yeah.
And no, actually the first song was okay, Okmalumkoolkat, got everybody looking like, who's that? You know?
Yeah, actually, yeah.
And then I put that on a phone's remix, like a random beat that I found online. And then I did Big Booty Holic on a Kraftwerk, a Trans Europe Express. Jay Dilla had done Big Booty Express on the Trans.
Oh yeah.
I was actually interested in how Jay Dilla, as a hip hop or neoclassic soul producer, was checking out Kraftwerk. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then with more research on like just music production and just like the history of music, I realized that techno is actually from Detroit, where Jay Dilla is from. So the drum machines and all of that stuff is literally from Detroit, and then it's getting picked up by these German guys who can actually make their own drum machines.
Yes,
now. That's Kraftwerk. So it's cool for him to go back and be like, "Lee, when I bring back that thing, But a lot of people don't understand that.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't understand that rock music is from black people. Yes. A lot of stuff is from.
Yeah.
But they don't want to go back and get it. Like, and be like, hey, actually,
we're so comfortable with what we're doing.
Yeah, now.
Yeah. We're like, exactly. If I've got this gospel thing to a T,
yeah, exactly.
I can't mess it up.
Yeah. So, yeah, just to answer your question, it's like I'm always, I always want to grab stuff from everywhere because, like, I think my biggest strength is like collaboration.
Yeah.
So with this album, I wanted to executive produce.
Yeah.
And just like flow my favorite beats.
I read this on the sleeve. So Future Mfana, producer, right?
Yeah, I produced the first track as Future Mfana.
Yes. And then, Okmalumkoolkat, artist.
Yeah.
Zap Zap.
DJ Shab Shab is a DJ, yeah.
DJ.
Yeah.
And then what, like, how, dog? How do you like how do you multi, like, you're like, yeah, okay, sharp, now I'm here. It's like you're in this movie or different movies and you're playing different characters.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm doing.
Ne?
I'm playing different characters in different movies. That's, literally.
Yeah.
Like Mlazi Milano is a headspace now, you know?
Yeah.
With this album is Mlazi Milano. If you listen to Holy Oxygen 1,
yeah.
It's Future Mfana.
Yeah.
You know, I'm talking about seeing it as a religion more. I'm in space.
Yeah.
I could go up to the moon and come back as Future Mfana. You know what I mean? Like, I'm really in the future.
Yeah.
But really in the past, like maybe first people, the red people.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
know
yeah.
What I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like crazy, crazy Zulu mythology stuff there.
But deep. Then,
yeah, exactly.
Deep stuff.
But so with that, it's like part fiction, part reality.
Yes.
Like in and out. But Okmalumkoolkat is more grounded, more here, more clubs.
Yeah.
More like, yo, what I'm doing. But Mlazi Milano now, it's become more Malum.
Yeah.
So like I'll talk about clubs, but it's like, maybe it's like the past.
Yeah.
Or I'm more clever now, more smart about it. You know what I mean? So, Zulu Computer will be, Zulu Computer is like the guy that used to rap with LV. Like Osebenza, all of that stuff.
Yeah. Yes.
My cassette is that crazy guy on 100K my cassette.
Yeah, yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like just different. It's like the headspace, I think.
Yeah. Let's talk about how important it is for the kids to know, to realize their potential. Because I feel like you untapped that potential and you're like, fuck it.
Yeah.
Agnanda, but like, I'm gonna do my thing.
Yeah, you can say it was moving in different spaces and not having like a stable home.
Yeah.
Actually kind of helped me to really understand, get to understand myself and other people and adapt, you know, very quickly. But I think the biggest thing that happened to me was like going to college.
Sure.
And well, the scholarship I got was really, really helpful in terms of unlocking my mind. Because like I got there and I had been dancing since I was 8.
Yeah.
Drawing since I was like 6, drawing, you know. And all the schools I went to didn't actually offer art.
Facilitate that.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I was always like, oh, that guy can
weird.
Draw.
Yeah.
He can draw.
But that's it.
That's it, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that guy can dance. You know what I mean? Yeah. So when I got that scholarship, I was like, when I got there, it wasn't like I was studying fine art. It was like, oh, okay, so you're already like this. We're going to teach you how to move through the creative process. We're going to teach you how to present. We're going to teach you how to brand yourself and stuff. And,
yeah.
You know, and just the whole push. because I started communication. So I think, yeah, that was the main thing. Like, so I guess the page is the one, like, you have to go study. And what's dope is studying for something you're passionate about.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think that's,
yeah, exactly,
more than anything. Because cinema, like, when I'll be honest with you, I didn't know any shit about college until I was, like, finishing my matric. And so,
and then it's like, yo, what am I going to do?
What am I going to do? Like, and I passed so well. And obviously, like, the calls start coming in from family. With, okay, so manje, what's your plan?
Yeah, bro. Yeah.
I obviously went back to the gang and we're like, yo, gents, so manje, like, what are you going to do?
Bro? Yeah. Ish.
That's the only time we all, like, actually decided, okay, shit, let's asabeni. See, like, some university of sorts,
yeah,
and just fucking browse, like, see your
and
research,
just check what's going on. Yeah, exactly.
Then we went, and then at the time, I know now, Uti, like, I wasn't prepped,
because
the escalator, like, didn't walk me through,
there was no career guidance,
I saw a campus for the first time. He's yelling at me now. And
yeah,
he was like, this big. I was like, shit.
Is this cool in there?
God damn. And then, like, the first thing was that I listened to everybody, what everybody was doing. I was like, so, like, if you took maths and you took science, oh, you can do marketing.
Yeah.
Shit, okay, cool. I think you're in the marketing. Right, I'm marketing class. Where do we sign up? This way.
Yeah.
And then all of us, I think 90% of the first years flunked. And that, for me, only when we were in college we realized how much other stuff existed.
Yeah,
we're like,
exactly.
I could have been fucking doing media. It's like, you can study media.
Yeah.
And and now I couldn't go back to my old lady and say, hey, babe, I feel so much in front of change.
The whole year.
Yeah. And she just, I left, go off. And she was like, hi, mama. This thing you're going to see through. But I dropped and I had to come back. But I think, man, boy, I came back with, like, perspective,
you know, exactly.
Which is shit.
Yeah.
Oh, actually,
yeah,
that's actually like a shit. But that information is not there. And for me, it's like, you made that connection, but obviously, because, like, how your mind works.
For me, it wasn't actually as easy as that. Also, because, like, I did my trick, and basically, I'm mad, so I didn't even have like hope with what I'm gonna do.
Yeah,
and then I tried, and then. And my old lady's like, okay, let's try textile. What about textile design? It's, yeah, actually, because I draw, you know, textile design. Went there. I was never prepped for the interviews.
Yeah.
So what is textile design? So, and then also, you know, I wasn't smart enough to go, okay, I'm going to go apply for interviews here and here, here.
Yeah.
I just went to one. Kawatege, stay the whole year.
Ego, yeah.
You got bruised.
Yeah, you're like, shit. No, can't go through that again.
Year, man. And then the next year, tried graphic design the next year. I was trying to go to the same tech at DUT in Durban.
Yeah.
What is graphic design?
Again.
I always just come with my file of my drawings, whatever, you know.
Guys, and I just want to do this.
Yeah. And then, so I was like, this is over. This is like 2 years after. But with that, I'm still busy dancing because I had a dance crew and we were quite popular.
Yeah.
And we were killing shows, killing competitions.
Yeah.
Like, we're the best in Durban at the time.
Sure.
But we're getting old now. It's like, yo,
matric
was 2 years ago.
Yeah, we can't be doing this.
You know, totally span, mind you, you know. Mm-hmm. Also, the club life. I'm in the club every weekend, you know. So when I got that scholarship, it was just like God coming in.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, literally. Here's my point. Actually, by the time I got to college, Giazaz is so much.
Yeah.
Me as a person, like,
weren't influenced by.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
And also, like, I think the one thing that kills a lot of South African youth is, like, the under pressure thing where it's like, oh, yeah, super seated now. Because kids are always waiting for the results. But I got Taba and Mosizo and Zan. A proper result. Yo.
Shit. Only now you have to jump, man.
Now it's like. And then now it's jumping on trends. So, yeah. What's trendy now is human relations.
Yeah.
It's exactly that. There was a. I don't know. About that.
Yeah. Fitness is in the IT.
Yeah, in IT.
Yeah, I'm going to shy. IT. Don't I am.
So I feel like. Yeah, I feel like that's one of the reasons, like, people just jump on trends. People are never sure if they're going to pass, first of all. And then secondly, I feel like there needs to be a culture of Ikepe as South Africa.
Ne?
Sikwala ma restaurant, span. Span, yeah. Span, yeah. But don't get stuck there. People get stuck.
Because culture,
no pause. Uspan, yeah, and then figure out what you need to, what you want to do, and then start doing it with that money. Start investing in whatever. You know what I mean? And then also, when people are there in college, people need to practice what they're studying. Like I know a lot of people, I've got cousins, we engineer, but I've never seen him
fix
enzy mod. Flyer.
Like, he's never next. Practiced. He's like, still, I'm leaving at school.
With a degree, ulinde span. So, yeah. I think that's the biggest flop in South Africa. Like, people study for marks, not for the actual thing. They're not passionate. Like, when I go to Austria, all the engineers there, like, if I'm meeting him, he's making something.
He's always like working in a garage.
He works for himself. Yeah. Everybody's working for themselves. So it's like,
that's a crazy link.
So that's what I did with my whole thing. Like, went to college, got the thing, and then I was like, oh, I'm gonna do this for myself. I don't have to work, especially because they're like, with these colleges, they're like, yeah, actually, you need to think out the box, and they open you up. But by the end of the year,
they lock you back.
No, they're like, okay, Hardiscaris is looking for people. But as far as I'm in the box.
Exactly,
I mean?
Yeah. So they shove you to the, it's like they the unlock again. You, and then they're like, manje ke nabo, wena uzongena la, ogulvi,
bani bani. Yeah, exactly.
Go.
Because, I wanted to go, me and Sanele and his brother, Uzamankolo, we wanted to go the other way, the whole time. Like, we wanted to start a studio. Like, I did Deli Parfum Zamani, you know? He did the beat on La Liga.
Yes.
So we've always wanted to go the other way, you know? And then, but impilo.
Ish, yeah, life happens.
So we'd end up working like odd jobs here and there. I worked as an intern graphic designer at the Department of Finance.
Yeah.
This is my first job in Joburg in 2007.
Sure.
And then I remember working there as an intern. And there was no mentor.
Yeah, shit.
So you're like an intern, but nobody knows what you do here. So you basically
teaching
everybody what you do and how it's done.
Yeah.
And don't send me a flyer now and expect it to be done in 30 minutes. Mm-hmm. But they were doing that before because they share my flying in the world.
Yes.
So now the flyers are not going to be like this. You know what I mean? So it was really interesting. But like at the same time, I'm getting like 3K. I'm an intern. And then I remember I had to wait for the permanent position. And then I started working at Nike, at the gallery in Melville.
Yes.
Like a concept store there. And then while I was doing that, I was laying out the newspaper at Sunday World.
Mm.
And then those people came back and they were like, okay, yeah, we got the permanent position. You're gonna get 25K. And I was like 24 at that point. I was like, I actually got scared of 25K.
Sure.
So I turned it down.
24,
turned it down.
Sure.
And I was getting like, maybe I was getting 8 here and I'll be getting like 6 there. It's getting like maybe 12, 13.
Yeah, my time is at my hustle.
But like my mom was covered, my rent is covered. It's still as a shower.
Yeah.
I'm learning more here at Nike because now I'm learning about marketing now.
Sure.
There, graphic design. And also, you know, like
working. The vibe.
Yeah, the vibe is not there.
Yeah, the vibe is like.
I just saw myself sitting at Capello. Yo, shout out to Capello. No bad luck. Saw myself at Capello with a big boob.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm old, 25K.
Shaihembe.
Shaihembe. Because I was a rebel at the office. I used to come like tank tops, nakindi.
Yeah, barely. Because the mind has been anti-establishment from day one. Exactly. Yeah.
And what's crazy is they used to chew me so much. The one time I'm in the lift with like one HOD from like floors below because he wasn't on my floor.
Yeah.
And then it's me and then the IT guy, white guy, who dresses punk. You know, like the
big black.
But they're used to him. So this guy's chewing me about my combo, my attire. And I'm like, Have you ever told him about his attack?
Yeah.
And it's like, ah, no, we all know this guy. And it's, yeah, but you've seen me for 6 months too.
How?
And then crazy. It was quite a crazy thing for him to adjust. Actually, I need to let you go too, you know? So, yeah, I think South Africa is still there. We still have to, even our own people still have to be like, yo, relax, yeah. relax.
You know? Yeah. Just go back to the music quickly before I let you go, dog. Dope chat, though.
Sure.
Why should people get Mlazi Milano? Why is it important? Why did you make it?
I think I really made it for the kids, man. Like, because looking at the soundscape right now in South Africa is like, it's a joke.
Yeah.
It's really it is. A joke. It's like, no, I'm not trying to diss anyone. It's a joke. It's like, you know?
It really is.
It's a joke. There's a couple cats doing like really good stuff, like trying to urge, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, we should be cutting edge now because the whole world is watching.
Yeah.
But we're not. And it's like, it's a bit sad because there's, now it's like, it's getting better in terms of there's money. People are putting money into the industry. Yeah. Like, when we started I remember.
Which is a positive, yeah.
Yeah, I remember we were getting shows ever. Like, kids used to book us ever.
Yeah.
The kids, like, maybe there's a group of kids, they've got the jewel. And that's like, it's 15, bang for now, about 10 dot. It's not 10.
Yeah.
That time, maybe just like 5 years ago.
Shit.
Then we'll track to the bar, they booked the hotel. This is before the brands were booking us, man. Book a hotel, throw a big show, give you cash like this.
Yeah.
And I'm like, these guys are so organized, man. You know what I mean? Like, and they're all the way in the bar.
Mm.
It's not so wet, it's the bar.
You understand
what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I always feel like kids in those townships are actually really, really more progressive than kids in a city townships. Well, Sharpeville.
Yeah.
So, exactly. So,
yep.
Yeah, man. So, I feel like right now, there's got to be that voice. Mlazi Milano is that voice. It's, oh, yeah, actually, I could do other stuff and I could rap in Tsonga. I could rap in isiZulu. I could make it dope. I could jump on an EDM beat. I could jump on a, you know, on a reggae beat and then do like some trap flows on them. You know, like just flip stuff around and make it exciting, you know?
The way you pick your features for this
For the album.
Project, yeah. How? Like how do you pick? How do you like, okay, Sharpens a 5 Omega la, and then, okay, Mashaya is like a standard procedure because you guys have that. That thing works. Mm. Yeah, but, but how do you then like how pick a ganjani? Like how do you like this one? No, I won't do this one.
It was strange. It was actually really strange because I listen to I ride my own wave half the time, you know. And Omasha, I just called him in the studio. I was like, "Yo, come through." So we started working at my house, and then he came to the actual studio, CSR Studios, and then he came. Like, I played him some beats that I wanted, you know? I probably had, like, 90 beats that I had to choose from. And then Masha is like, yeah, no, I got this beat from a DJ, Aubrey Mbofu. It was his DJ at the time. So, that became Matananaza.
Oh, yes.
Like, wow, actually, that's crazy. So, we started working on that track, you know?
Yeah.
Super Mega, we probably met, like, maybe 2 times, 3 times. I played him like 9, I confused him.
Yeah.
Played him 9 beats. We rapped on like 2. There's actually other stuff that we rapped on
that didn't come out.
Yeah. And then Mega Milano was like, at some point he wasn't actually even feeling it. I was like, yo man, this is crazy. Because there, the beat is like, I'm Zulu Michael Jackson, he's Super Mega. You understand what I'm saying? Like, the beat is like, some other. And the beat is by Sidrim. We did Holy Oxygen together.
Yes.
He's from Vienna. So, you know, stuff like that. Ricky, I call him up for Sele was supposed to be on a Boys and Bucks mixtape. And it never really came out. And it's always been close to my heart. Like, yo, this track would kill if it saw the light of day. So, yeah, Sele, Amadando actually called me with that, with the hook.
Like, yeah.
Yo, we got a new one, guys. Because they write a lot of music. But yeah, man, because we're freestyling maybe a week before with them. They're like, yo, we got a new one. Bali, Malu.
Yeah.
Dab Dab in Dololuan, because I was rapping La Liga to them.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, Dab Dab in Dololuan. So they hoed it. Yeah, and I was like, yeah, this is dope, man. So, Sisha, yeah. Ushoma Josie actually hit me up online. I said, yo, man, I want to be your ghostwriter.
Yeah.
You just send me the raps. She records some raps. She sounded like me. It was actually really scary because she sounded like me, but maybe 4 years, 5 years ago.
What?
But not like the same. It won't be the same, obviously.
Yeah. Mara, you could feel yourself come through. Yo, yes. Like,
you know, you could see she could actually go and make another me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But, shit. Well, it won't work, but like she could.
Mm-hmm.
You
know? Mm-hmm. So she had the right ingredient.
But I was like, I've never worked with a ghostwriter. So I was like, aye. Then I was like, if you're that good, what are you writing? She's a poet anyway.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
She's like, no, I do poetry, but I don't rap. I'm like, yeah, you can definitely rap.
Yeah.
Can't do nah, my verse. I keep
on. Whoop it. Whoop it.
And then, so that's how she ended up on Tongue for Action.
Yeah, you actually, like, and you she's fucking catapulted that.
Yeah, man.
She's, like, the most talked about.
Yeah, true. In every, like. And it's, like, it's quite a sad thing for to be in 2017 and you've never heard a song or rap.
Right?
Because nobody was questioning it. Nobody was questioning it, you know what I mean?
Yeah. It's like, it's always been there.
Yeah.
Shit, come
like,
on,
like, there's
guys.
No...
You're
there's
right, no actually. Twana the R&B soundscape track. Is trash right now.
There's no Twana R&B track. There's no Zulu R&B track. You okay. Understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, slow chance of some Mlazi.
Now
we got you, man.
Yeah, so it's like... Yeah, it's all those things. And she speaks like 10 languages, so what? You can imagine. Reba was the same.
Damn,
like,
yeah.
It's somebody I knew in the scene. And then I check her Instagram. We didn't born how we are cool. You say, oh, what's good, Anje? Zwagas, he's shy.
Yeah.
So, yeah, a lot of people were just like, while I was working on the album, because I didn't have set features, which I
yeah.
And I had so much of a thing to choose from.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then, so that's how it ended up being. If you notice, every track on an album has a partner. Everything is in twos. Like the intro goes with the outro.
Yes, exactly.
And then Matananazana goes with the Malobola. And then, you understand what I'm saying? La Liga and Sele Sele. Everything.
Actually,
like,
yes.
Yeah.
Fuck.
So it's See? Either if you're not here, then you're there. You
yeah.
Know? So.
That's crazy, dog. Mm. Visuals, what can we expect? Visuals, what's the plan there?
I'm literally shooting the music video next week in Mlazi.
Uh-huh.
We're gonna go down to Durban. And then other stuff I don't wanna talk too much.
Yeah,
we wanna work on a short film.
Shange, yeah.
Yeah, we wanna work on a short film, we wanna do people want all the visuals.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
It feels
like you can do like visuals for every song.
Yeah, that means I won't have money.
Yeah.
And then also, that means, because we're in South Africa, you know, I think it'll be dope if some of the stuff that we do online would just be let alone online.
Yeah.
But I remember I did, like when it came, like I said, it was meant for digital.
Yeah.
That's why I didn't clear the samples.
Yeah.
Shout out to Mdu, man, I'm sorry. But.
OG.
It was literally, you know, it's like, growing up and you be listening to Lil Wayne and you can grab any beat.
Yeah, I
for
shy.
Online. For
online,
the internet.
Yeah, it's not selling it.
So what happens in
and
South
that
Africa,
became a culture actually.
Yeah, man. So what happens in South Africa, you do that, then the radio is like, oh yeah, sure, Issa, by far.
Issa, yeah.
The sample is not cleared. You shy video for YouTube by Tat, by Fire TV.
Yeah.
So imagine now you do, I do all the tracks. I do videos for all the tracks.
Yeah.
What happens is, by the end of the year, you guys are tired of my face.
Yeah.
Because everything's going to end up on TV.
Yeah.
But if I know I'm going to put like 4 for TV.
Yeah.
And then the rest will go on the internet and nobody will touch them, then they'll be dope. But like, yeah.
You can't restrict it.
You can't
restrict it.
But sure. That's the thing. You oversaturate yourself.
Yeah.
So it's a strange one. How do you do it? You know?
Nah.
Yeah.
So it's like a wave.
Yeah, because I guess even the singles now, like I had other plans, but now I'm just listening to more people on Twitter telling me, Amalobolo is next, though.
Yeah, no, Amalobolo, dog.
Because
no,
Mega Milano is like, yeah, third quarter, but people are like, Mega Milano now.
We want everything now. But let's say, we're like, yo, La Liga now. Bro.
Now.
Yeah. Even Mlazi Milano, yo, the painting.
Yeah, exactly.
My G. Like, yeah, it's like, crazy. Shit, it's so clear.
Yeah, sure.
You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah,
the song.
Yeah,
the song.
Yeah,
the, Mlazi Milano, the song.
Yeah, the title track.
So fucking clear, dog. Like, you get it. I'm like, damn. I was telling my girl the other day, like, there's a line where you were talking about your grand giving you guap to take a taxi.
Yeah.
And then she even sponsored you Young Farmer Suite.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm like, Jesus. And she's like, how is that dope? I'm like,
nobody's
you
talking
gotta
about
get
it.
That. You like, really, like, you must have experienced it to know that feeling. It's such a sweet
thing.
Spot.
Yeah, exactly,
such a sweet
exactly.
Spot. It's crazy though. You
but
do
also,
that a lot.
Cats are not talking about themselves, you know.
So they're talking about what they are thinking
they
would be.
And also what my favorite rapper would say.
Yeah, exactly.
And his favorite rapper is from maybe Atlanta.
And he's talking about, isn't it? Exactly. Atlanta?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's crazy, dog. You did it, dog, with this album.
Man,
for
thanks.
Real. You did a
I
great
hope the kids
fucking
get
job.
It,
look, they'll get it, dog. It might not be now, but you know that
yeah,
they'll
exactly.
Get
it's
it.
It's going to work.
It's going to work out. I'm learning your language, dog.
Yeah.
You do this thing with the language. Yeah. I need you to explain a few things that I thought I knew. Now I'm going to sense check myself. What does Makangi mean? What does Mutswaps?
Mutswaps is a pari.
Okay. Ah, we don't deal with the Mutswaps.
Yeah, I'm pari.
Straight
like,
up.
If you're not trying to be smart about it.
Ite. What is it? What kind of sound? You in that it?
Ite, I actually don't even know how to explain it. But like, growing up in Durban, ite would be like, let's say the teacher is out. Eh?
Yeah.
And then everyone's like wildlife for a minute, and then maybe you go a bit overboard and you break something.
Yeah.
Like the whole class would be like, ite,
okay.
Just to be like, yo,
like,
you're in trouble. Yeah.
Palolo.
Yeah,
yeah. Okay, cool.
Yeah, man.
Makangi?
Magangi is like shandis, so anything, like this is my Magangi and this is a Magangi.
Sure.
Oh, that's say Magangi, you know what I mean, like article, merchandise, shandis.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
Like, yeah, South African slang is actually weird.
It's weird.
Because shandis is for merchandise.
Oh, snap.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
yeah,
it could
yeah.
Be anything.
Anything, yeah.
You know,
it could be anything.
Like, yeah, but we're dealing with slang like otherwise.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, otherwise could be anything.
Or even sharp.
Yeah, otherwise could be, how are you? Yeah, like, otherwise, not.
Otherwise is, how are you, but really, really, how are you?
Yeah, really.
Like, really, really? Like, no worries. But I think the craziest one for me is, like, sharp.
Yeah.
Because, like, I use it on email. Like, so if I'm talking to someone, like, there's a friend of mine, he's from the UK. His name is OK Sharp now.
Yeah.
Because I used to send my emails to him, OK Sharp, at the time. Remember?
Yeah.
Like, OK Sharp, what do you mean? He's like, as in like, thanks, as in
good.
It's done.
Yeah.
Then he's like, how does Sharp get to that? Because
it means a completely different thing.
It's like,
yeah.
It's like Sharp, like they got Sharp. So that means, okay, already in the English language, if you say somebody's smart and you use Sharp.
Yeah.
You're already in slang.
Yes.
So how does it get to from smart
to okay,
it's all good.
Yeah, it's not.
You know, it's like, so there's a lot of, I think there's a lot of things in South Africa that
yeah,
just like, wow.
That can be done still.
That make me feel like it's, you know, it's a really, really good place. We've got like 11 languages. We can play around so much.
Sure, yeah, yeah. Ikombo, the importance, what's the importance of gear, dog?
Speaking without speaking. Yeah, exactly.
Dope,
just talking without talking. But just as a form of expressing, you know?
Yeah.
Like, in a way.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I remember like, traveling to Europe, and I'm wearing, like, a yellow jacket.
Yeah.
And nobody out there is wearing a yellow jacket.
Shit.
So it's like...
Yeah.
It's still an African thing to express through
to
the thing.
Yeah.
Like, when you go abroad, kids are, like, navy, black, gray.
Yeah.
But if you want to see that it's really, really styling, then you have to go come close, look at the fabrications,
like, yeah,
look at the
you,
branding,
yeah,
you know what
yeah,
I mean?
Like,
yeah.
This is
it's like that.
Yeah.
There. But here it's like, I think even if I move that side, it's still gonna be like crazy, yeah. crazy. Cause like I dress how I feel in the morning. You know what I mean?
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. But.